Hi, my name is Imtiaz Hussain. I'm a senior escalation engineer supporting Microsoft Windows Azure. Today, I'll be talking about Windows Azure Diagnostics, how it works, and how it can be configured. Windows Azure Diagnostics enables you to collect diagnostic data from an application running in Windows Azure. Windows Azure Diagnostics fulfills two design requirements introduced by the Windows Azure scale-out architecture. One, to save diagnostic data that would be lost during a re-imaging of the instance, and two, provide a central repository for diagnostics from multiple instances. Using Windows Azure Diagnostics, you can collect diagnostic data off of multiple instances at once. The architecture of Windows Azure Diagnostics is to first collect data on the instance and then persist the data to Windows Azure storage. The Diagnostics Monitor runs in Windows Azure and in the Windows Azure Compute Emulator to collect diagnostics data from a role instance. If the Diagnostics module has been imported into the service model for a role, the Diagnostics Monitor automatically starts when a role instance starts. Data sources must be added to the diagnostics configuration to collect diagnostic data. If you don't explicitly configure the Diagnostics Monitor, the default configuration will be used when the role starts. Only some of the available data sources are added to the Diagnostics Monitor by default. You can configure the collection of other data sources using the diagnostics.wad.cfg file, and we'll talk more about this shortly. Diagnostics data will be collected and stored on the role instance, but will not be persisted to storage unless you specify a storage account in the service configuration.csCFG file. After the diagnostics data is collected, it can be transferred to a Windows Azure storage account for persistence. Transfers can either be scheduled or on demand. This allows you to save the data that may otherwise be lost due to re-imaging, and also provides a centralized repository from multiple instances. By default, diagnostics logs are not persisted, so you will need to decide how much data you want to collect and when the logs should be transferred. Windows Azure Diagnostics can be configured using several different mechanisms as listed here in the precedence order for how the diagnostic monitor applies configuration information. The preferred mechanism is to configure diagnostics using an XML configuration file called the diagnostics.wad.cfg. Using this approach, the diagnostics file completely defines the configuration and it can be updated and redeployed at will. Using the config file approach has other advantages over programmatic approach. For example, diagnostics starts before the onStart method is run, so errors in startup tasks can be caught and logged. Another advantage is that the changes to diagnostics configuration do not require the code to be rebuilt. A control configuration blob will be created for each role instance whenever a role without a blob is started. The WAD control container blob has the highest precedence for controlling behavior, and any changes to the blob will take effect the next time the instance polls for changes. The default polling interval is once per minute. The set current configuration method updates the WAD control container blob directly and will result in a new configuration taking effect on the next polling interval. This is the preferred mechanism for setting configuration programmatically. When a role imports the diagnostics module by using the service definition, the diagnostics module looks for a file called diagnostics.wad.cfg in the root directory of the worker role or the bin directory of the web role. If the configuration file exists in one of these locations when the diagnostics module is imported, the diagnostics monitor uses this config file for its settings. The default configuration will be used if none of the above approaches have been used to update the configuration. By default, Windows Azure logs, IIS logs, and Windows Azure diagnostic infrastructure logs are collected locally but are not persisted to storage. After you have deployed a cloud service, you can remotely change the configuration of the diagnostics monitor. Once a diagnostic monitor is started, it will continuously poll storage for a special file that gives it its configuration. You can update this file locally on your machine, either manually or using Diagnostics API, and save it to the storage container. And the role will pick it up during the next polling interval and update itself. Here are some useful links. In this talk, we have looked at an introduction to Windows Azure Diagnostics and its configuration mechanisms. Thank you.